Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Today we have a topic with us, it's called Profitability Index. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Now see, when we talk about Profitability Index, it is more related to the capital budgeting process. Over here, if you see, there is details regarding the cash flows details are given, and then it has been discounted. Okay, so we will try and learn this concept in a much more deeper way. First, you know, profitability index is what exactly? See, it is basically nothing but a ratio. What is it? It is a ratio of the present value. Ratio of the, first, let me write, what is profitability index? Now, it is the ratio of the PV, that is the present value of the future cash flow of the project, and to the initial investments in the project. So these index helps in, you know, nothing but the cost benefit analysis. That is the important thing of any investment projects, and it helps them, you know, in rank in order of their best turn on their initial investment. Now in this tutorial we will discuss how can you use this index, you know, to find out whether this project is worthy of investment or not. Well, first we have to understand what exactly is profitability index. Now see, imagine that you need to make some sort of investment. Let's say you need to make an investment, and what do you need to do? So you need to make nothing but a cost benefit analysis that you need to do, okay, to understand whether these investment that you are about to make is profitable for you or not. Now the same goes for the companies. Now every company, when it decides to invest into a project, they need to know beforehand whether the investment would be profitable or not. Now if not, why should they invest their money into the project? The question. Now it does not make sense, right? So how do they know whether the investment would be good for them to invest in? Now simply when the benefit from the benefit, okay, remember this. When the benefit from the investment, if this exceeds the cost of investment, and there lies the issue. Now, when the company will receive the benefit, so it will be the future, not now. Okay, it's not going to be now. You're going to receive your benefit in future. So if they compare the expected future value with the current investment, right, then there would be a missing link. And as a company, it's foolish to expect nothing would change during the course. So, and if the present value of the future cash flows is more than what the company is investing into the project, then the company can go ahead and invest into the project. Why not? So this is called as the profitability index. Now, the ratio of the present value of the future cash flow, FCF, present value of the FCF of the project, to the initial investment, okay, in the project. So these ratio helps in nothing but the cost benefit analysis, majority of them, and they help them in ranking in order of the best return on their initial investment. Now in this section, you know, the next one, you know, we'll go further and understand, you know, how a company decides whether they should accept the project by using PI or not. Okay, the second point of discussion is the formula part. Now if you see the profitability index formula, it is important because using this, you or any of your company would be able to calculate the PI, and those would be able to decide whether to invest in a project or not. Okay, so F1, that is formula number one, let's evaluate. PI, that is your profitability index, is equal to your present value of future cash flow divided by the initial investment that is required. So the profitability index formula does look very simple here. All you need to do is to find out the present value of the future cash flows and then divide it by the initial investment of the project. However, there is another way through which we express PI, and that is through the net present value. Okay, this method is good measure well, you know, it considers whether any investment is profitable or not. But in this case, the idea is to find the ratio and not the amount part. Here, I'm talking about here. Okay, now let's talk about F2, that's the formula number two. Let's have a look at the PI, formula number two, which says PI, profitability index, is equal to 1 plus the NPV, net present value, divided by the initial investment that has been required. This is another formula by which you can evaluate. See, if we compare both of them or both these profitability index formula, they both will give the same result, but they are just differ the way they look at the PI. Okay, we got what exactly goes into the formula, but how about if we learn something about the components part, the component of the profitability index formula? Well, see, here you need to pay heed to few component which you need to use while to calculate the profitability index. The first thing is you need to use the present value. Well, we will take a very simple example to illustrate. Let's say that you want a loan, okay, some money to one of your friends. Now your friend say that, you know, he would return the money, let's say after a year time span. He is ready to return your money after a year time span. With he says that, you know, I'll give you 10% return. Now, if you give loan to him, you know that the expected future value, that is the expected amount you would receive after 1 year, is going to be $100. Now you need to find out the present value here, present value of that amount, present value of that amount. Okay, and how would you do it? See, the simple way that you can do is, the formula is your present value is equal to the future value that you are supposed to get divide by 1 plus R, that is the 1 plus R, that is the R is your discounting rate raised to N for the number of years. So you are simply considering 1 as principal amount here and I as the interest, okay, as the number of years. So by using this formula, you can find out how much you should loan to justify the investment. And if we calculate over here, PV is equal to your future value divided by 1 plus the formula. So our answer is going to be 100 divided by bracket 1 plus 0.1 because it's 10% raised to 1 year. So we get closely around approximately 91. So if you loan him 91, it would justify the investment. Okay, the second component is the initial investment. Now, the initial investment required is basically the amount you want to let go because you want to enhance your wealth. So to say it in a different manner, you are investing your money into a project because you find it more profitable than any other project at this moment. The third is your NPV, net present value. So in simple terms, the net present value is basically the difference between the present value of the cash flow, that is the inflow, the present value of the cash inflow, minus the present value of the cash outflow. Like for example, you calculate the present value of the future, let's say a project of $1,000 and your initial investment required is, let's say, $900. So then the net present value over here is 100. So it just say that, you know, if you want to invest in a project, then the net present, the present value should always be positive, as like over here you can see. So you shouldn't invest in a project if the project offers you negative or neutral on, of the net present value. So you can consider neutral NPV if all the projects of your negative NPV. And in the example section, we saw the same thing. Now, after working on this, I'll give you a quick way of how to interpret. See, if your index over here, if this is 1, then the investment is worthy, okay? Because then you may earn back more than what you have invested exactly. So if you find any investment whose PI is more than 1, go ahead and invest. It's fine. Now, if the investment, this is greater than 1. Now, if it is less than 1, then in that scenario, it's better to step back and look for the opportunities, because when PI is less than 1, that means you would not get back the money you would invest. And why bother to invest at all? And when it is equal to 1 in that particular scenario, that is equal to if this is equal to one, then in that particular scenario, you know, you shouldn't invest. I mean, that's an indifferent case or neutral project. You shouldn't invest in the project until unless you consider if it better than other projects available during the period. So if you find that PI of all the projects is negative, then they consider investing in this particular project. So after discussing all the variables that was available with us in the final analysis, if you see, PI is a great metric to use when you need to decide whether you need to invest in something or not. Now, if you have a company and you are in a tight budget, then these metric would help you to decide whether you should consider investing in a new project or not. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and liked the video, if you think that if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.